What if I told you that you could make these delicious, fluffy, eggless custard donuts? This incredibly cheesy oven-baked pizza? And this pillowy, soft cinnamon rolls, all with just one dough, without yeast and in under 30 minutes. Are you surprised? Well, don't be, because today I am showing you this no yeast crazy magic dough. With just this one dough, you can make unlimited bread recipes, and I'll be showing them all to you in the coming videos. But let's first begin with this dough. In the bowl of my stand mixer, I have taken some all-purpose flour. To that, now I'm going to add some sea salt, baking powder and baking soda. So that's right, when we replace the yeast, we are not going to be using any yeast. Instead of that, we'll be adding these as the leavening agent. So I have baking powder, baking soda, and then also some sea salt to season the dough. Once I've added that in, I'm going to use my dough hook attachment for my stand mixer, and on a very slow speed, just mix until it is just combined. Now it's time to add some liquid ingredients. Here I have some store-bought yogurt, and I'm also be going to add in some lukewarm milk. Now the milk is lukewarm, meaning if I dip my finger into the milk, I'll be able to do that very, very comfortably and I won't be flinching, it won't hurt me. So that's how the temperature should be. Now you'll notice that there is no water in this recipe. I will not be adding any water. The soft and fluffy dough that we get is from adding the yogurt and the milk, and it adds an incredible amount of tenderness. Now this dough needs to be first kneaded on a slow speed until just the flour comes together. You can see that there's a lot of spare bits of flour on the side which have still not mixed with the dough. So I'm going to use my spatula, and with the help of my spatula, just get it right in the center, and then on a medium speed I'll start mixing this, and once that's combined, then I'll crank up the speed to medium high and then knead this for a good 5 minutes. Now, because I'm filming this video and I'm the only person who works on these videos, I could not really knead this dough by hand because that would create a very sticky, messy situation handling my camera. But you can be assured that when I make this at home on my own, I always knead this by hand. So if you're kneading this by hand, it'll take about 10 to 12 minutes. You'll see how initially the dough was so sticky, sticking to the sides of the bowl, but now it's super, super clean, and that's when you know that the dough is ready. It is sticky and tacky, but it does not stick to the surface. So that's the consistency you want. Now oil the palm of your hands and collect that dough into a ball, and then grease very lightly a glass bowl or a steel bowl or a metal bowl, and just place that dough and cover it with a damp cloth for about 15 minutes minimum. Now you can rest this dough for up to 2 to 3 hours. You can even rest this dough in the refrigerator overnight, but just be sure that when you use it the next day, let it come down to room temperature. Now that this dough has rested, I am just going to put it on my work surface, dust it with flour, and I'm just going to peel this dough off from the bottom. And you may have noticed I did not flour the surface before putting that dough on. And you can see I'm easily able to pull that dough away from the work surface without it sticking to it. But as a general rule of thumb, I would always recommend that you flour the surface before you use the dough. Now I'm just going to shape the dough. As you can see the seams over there, and that's not what you want. So you're going to pinch the dough and then just kind of roll the dough and massage the dough in a way with the palms of your hands so that it forms a nice cohesive dough ball. And then you're just going to begin using this in a number of different ways. I am going to show you in the coming weeks the different bread recipes you can make. You can bake this, you can fry this, you can even cook it on a skillet, and I'm going to show you all of those recipes. We're going to be making this delicious eggless custard donuts, fried balls of heaven filled with delicious vanilla custard. I'm also going to be showing you this incredibly addictive pizza. We've been having pizza every week, guys, ever since I started making that dough. And I'm also going to show you how to make these fluffy, pillowy cinnamon rolls with an orange glaze and tons of other recipes. Next week, I'm showing you how to make this incredible pizza, which is made on a skillet. It has no yeast, no cheese, and you don't even need an oven to make it. So subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so you get the notification. If you like this recipe, then hit the like button, and I will see you again next week. Until then, goodbye and happy baking.